Hi, Sheree. Yes, the highway I-75 north in the Arlington Heights, Lachlan area does remain shut down at this hour. You can see the plane is still on the interstate. You can see the tail of the plane right there. To the right of it, there is a vehicle. That's Cincinnati Police's crash response unit. And last we talked to Cincinnati Police, they were still waiting for investigators from the FAA to arrive.
A view from the ground shows how this single-engine plane came to a stop against the concrete barrier. Ryan Carpenter shot this video. He was driving on 75 North and saw the plane go down in front of him.
I was probably 15 feet away from it when it landed after I slammed on my brakes. Slid probably about 20, 25 feet into the concrete barrier.
Shortly before the crash, Rob Martin of Hartwell was sitting in his backyard when he heard a plane and looked up.
Was flying very low, and the plane was, the engine was backfiring, you know, and really sounded to me like, you know, the plane was in distress because it was flying, you know, lower and lower.
Martin called 911.
You know, in all probability, this plane is not going to be able to get to an airport.
I seen an airplane, I was like, wait a minute, did they build an airport around here in the last couple of days? And next thing you know, I just seen them come down. Like,
on 75, near Ronald Reagan, without hitting any cars.
Nobody got injured, luckily, surprisingly.
Cincinnati police say the pilot reported engine trouble before the crash landing. The plane is registered to a company in Indianapolis. A check of past flights showed trips were made between Indy and Lunkin, and the FAA confirms the pilot was en route to Lunkin again today.
And again, I-75 North between Galbraith and Davis remains shut down at this hour. Cincinnati police are waiting for investigators from the FAA to get here, and they have not been able to tell us when they expect the stretch to reopen. Reporting live tonight in Arlington Heights, Karen Johnson, WLWT News 5.